is a teacher performance assessment that all teacher candidates must complete. A passing score on the edTPA is required for licensure in the state of Wisconsin. Teacher candidates in the Secondary Science Education Program complete the Secondary Science edTPA during the student teaching semester. Science teacher candidates placed in a middle school during the student teaching semester have the option of selecting an alternative edTPA handbook for science at the middle school level to complete. However, you should discuss this option with the Secondary Science Education Program Coordinator. Completing the Secondary Science edTPA helps to develop your pedagogical skills as a science teacher, and obtaining a passing score on the edTPA is considered to be one measure of your ability to teach science. The edTPA requires a large amount of time, a significant amount of work, and attention to detail. You need to start thinking about how you will accomplish what is in the handbook within the first 2 weeks of your student teaching placement. This initial planning includes working with your cooperating teacher and your university supervisor to identify the class hour or period of students you will be working with for the edTPA. As part of the assessment requires you to video record your teaching, you must have written permission forms from parents or guardians prior to filming the students. Take careful note of the due date for the Secondary Science edTPA. This is typically announced when you meet with your university supervisor during the required student teaching meeting on campus. With that due date in mind, you should work backwards to plan out what you need to do for each of the three major tasks: planning, instruction, and assessment. Do not think of the three tasks sequentially as you plan. Instead, consider them collectively. You must have knowledge of your students, and you must know what you will assess and how you will assess them to decide upon what to include in your lesson plans and how you will plan your instruction. Do set target dates to complete complementary drafts and related documents for each task. You should plan to have final drafts of all of your edTPA documents ready to submit 2 days prior to the due date to allow any potential issues with uploading. Make sure that you include all documents and components described in the edTPA handbook. Fully answer each of the prompts in the templates. The prompts are very detailed. Make sure you specifically address each part. If you do not pass the edTPA on your first attempt, you will need to resubmit. What you will need to resubmit depends on your score profile. The three most crucial edTPA supportive documents that you should study in depth are the edTPA Secondary Science Assessment Handbook, the Understanding Rubric Level Progressions for Secondary Science edTPA, and the edTPA Making Good Choices.